everybody. Here we go!
Good day, everyone. And hello from Epcot. You can see Spaceship Earth looming in the background here. Today, we are really excited to be here. I mean, Epcot's amazing on its own, but we're also going to check out the Festival of the Arts, which I've never done that festival before. Have you ever done a festival?
No.
No, okay.
Last time I was here was 12 years ago. Even if I did a festival, I don't remember it.
Fair. See, I've done the Flower and Garden Festival before, because I usually come during my merch break back in high school, but yeah, this is fun because I really wanted to experience this for a long time. And it's very construction-y around here, so this might be interesting to navigate when we're in Future World. But yeah, we're super excited to begin our day and see what we come across. We're headed to Ratatouille now, so without any further ado, let the adventures
begin
in Epcot. Me too. There we go. Well, not that one, this one. Okay, so our first ride of the day, we did Remy's Ratatouille Adventure.
It was really awesome. Definitely get here early though, because...
Oh yeah, that line got big real quick.
Yeah, I think we were in there for about an hour.
Yeah, sounds about right. Maybe a little over.
Yeah, and when we saw the end of the line, it said 180 minutes.
Yeah,
and
so...
when we got in the line, it was only supposed to be 90 maybe? We at least got on quick.
Yeah. But yeah, it was so fun. I have done a trackless dark ride, the SeaWorld one, but that was nothing compared to this.
Yeah. French bread.
We did. Speaking of French bread, we are on our way to try to find some breakfast.
Yeah, I'm starving.
Oh, me too. So we had a heck of a time trying to find some food. So we are here at the Sunshine Grill in the Land Pavilion. I got a stir fry, a chicken stir fry. And Michael, you just got a burger, right?
A bacon cheeseburger.
Yum, we're hungry, so we're gonna eat this now. Bye.
Please take a seat. Store all carry-on items in the under-seat compartment. This includes cameras, purses, hats, and of course, these little beauties.
Thank you. Ready to fly?
Ready.
So we just got off of Soarin', and Michael, this is your first time experiencing the around the world version.
Yeah.
What'd you think of it?
I could smell grass.
Yeah.
I'm happy.
Soarin' has always been one of my favorites, and I mean, I think I still prefer the over California version, but you can never go wrong with Soarin'. And now we're in line for the most iconic ride here at Epcot, Living with the Land. We're gonna learn about food. It's fun, I promise, it's fun.
Now and into the future. These are just a few of the edible plants that have been an important source of nutrition for people living in the tropics. Tilapia, bass, and catfish are the ones you see here. Are three of the more popular crops raised by fish farmers. This is thousands of pounds of fish each year to serve at restaurants. Innovations like this can plant in sorghum and millet plus rice account for nearly two-thirds of our global food consumption.
Find out what NFTs are.
The future of agriculture may include innovative ideas like this vertical growing system. Plants grown in this way use a fraction of the space required by traditional growing methods. Another great way to produce more while using less.
So of course you can't go to the Festival of the Arts without visiting the king himself, Figment. So we are on our way to Journey to Imagination with Figment. Let's go. So I have never done Journey to Imagination myself, so this will be my first time. I'm pretty excited. Figment's an icon, and now I gotta visit his shrine.
That's creative.
Hello! On your tour, you'll see how the five human senses can help capture your imagination.
Oh, can I go too?
Absolutely not. This is one of our discoveries, the figment of imagination.
Yeah, I know all about the senses. Their sight, sound, smell, touch, cookie, cookie, go, and taste. Taste like chicken. Please.
No, I don't want you out of my sight.
Out of sight? Okay, come on everybody, here we go!
It's not about listening with your ears, it's about listening with your imagination.
What is going on? You're turning this entire open house upside down.
Upside down? Now you're talking.
With just a spark of inspiration, I made my house an innovation.
Of course, we're visiting during the Festival of the Arts, but the Epcot Flower and Garden Festival is also coming up in March, and it looks like they've started to plant the flowers that are normally over here. I usually go to the parks in March, so this is usually what I see when I come, but yeah, it's great to see that there's preparations already taking place. All right, and what used to be the Energy Pavilion, we now have Guardians of the Galaxy Cosmic Rewind opening up later this year. Unfortunately, not during our trip. I kind of wish it was. You can see the little spaceship in front. I forget the actual name, the Nova Core Blaster. I haven't seen the movie in so long. But yeah, there it is. We are so close.
I've never seen Guardians of the Galaxy.
It's good. I will have to make you watch it.
America, now connecting from the Atlantic to the Pacific.
Now, please, I'm sorry that line is busy.
All right, so we just hit Spaceship Earth, which was wonderful as always. Love that ride. And then Mike had the idea to wander into the gift shop. And as you can see, we have ears. We've been seeing them all over the place and we're like, we should get them. And then we decided to go for it. Brag to our kids in the future that we have 50th anniversary years.
They don't.
They don't.
Maybe we'll let them inherit them.
Maybe. We'll see.
I might want to take them with
me. I mean, we paid a pretty penny, might as well get a full worth out of them. But no, these are actually the first ears that I've ever owned. I've never had ears as a kid, and yeah, neither have you. So this is a very big moment, a momentous occasion. That's the word I was looking for. Say cheers, we have ears. All right, Michael, are you ready to blast off soon?
Yes.
Good. Okay, we are in Club Cool, and I have decided to take the challenge and try some Beverly. It's not as bad as I was expecting, but it tastes like grapefruit.
It's kind of how I expected Italian stuff to taste.
Yeah, like it has a grapefruit flavor. Is that what I'm detecting?
Yeah, maybe blood orange.
Mm. It was better than I thought it was going to be. Let's just say that. Not great. But I was expecting the worst. One cool part of the Festival of the Arts is that you have a lot of local artists setting up booths and everything. And a lot of them come up with some really nice Disney-inspired stuff. Like this cute little Figment one, it is perfect. Like this, it perfectly represents the festival as a whole. So you have some classic Disney characters. This booth is all the work of Tim Rogerson, by the way. If I film a booth, I should probably shout out the artist. So, Tim Rogerson. I want all of it.
I'm poor.
Ooh, look at these like impressionist style paintings. Oh my goodness. These are awesome. Tangled.
Yeah, I saw Chloe.
Oh yes, Chloe, we have Merida here for you. On to our second booth here. Oh, we have Casey Jr. So cute. Those two were done by Morgan Dita. Haunted Mansion. Love it. Ooh, we also have some red representation from Pirates of the Caribbean, so that's cool. Two awesome attractions inspired ones. These ones are done by Kim Grummel. So, we have made it back to the Encanto booth. This is a booth that has some Colombian inspired food. We had a cast member recommend this place to us earlier in the morning from Selena over at, yeah, your bestie. But it was closed, so now we're back and we're excited to try it out. Line is a little long, but we'll make do. So yeah, here at the Encanto booth, you can get a house-made chorizo and potato empanada, which is probably what we're gonna get. That sounds delicious. A spicy ajiaco soup, and I apologize if I pronounced that wrong. I'm Canadian, I never learned Spanish, don't come for me. And a passion fruit mousse. As well as some cool drinks, like the coconut and passion fruit smoothie. That's what Selena recommended to us, and that's probably what we'll get because that sounds delicious and so refreshing. It's really hot out today, so we kind of need that. Here we go. We got the chorizo and empanada, as well as the coconut fruit smoothie. These look absolutely delicious. Michael, you've taken your first bite. How is it?
So good.
My turn. I will have to see if that is a correct statement. Mm-hmm. That was so good. Amazing. And of course, we get to eat this meal right by some art. It doesn't say who the artists are, but we have some signed favorites. Is there a sign?
They're signed.
Oh, they're signed. Okay. But they are very, very nice. Michael's going to try the coconut passion smoothie and tell us how it is.
It's pretty good. Okay. It's more coconutty than I anticipated, but it's pretty good.
So our dinner at the Encanto booth was really good, I'd say.
It was more of a lunch.
Well, more of a lunch, yeah. It wasn't a lot, but we hope to see the Broadway show later. For now, we're going to check out some stores along the way. Hey, Michael, what's a camel's favorite day of the week?
Wednesday.
Why?
Because it's
hump day. Oh, yeah. Another cool art booth here. I think this one is all the same artist. Alright, before we head over to our show, I'm gonna head into Michikoshi. There's basically a Japanese department store. And I was kind of going for that style anyways. Oh my goodness, so cute. Oh my goodness. They have a little KK Rider plush.
So cute.
And a lot of cool backpacks, a lot themed to different characters and anime and stuff like that. And there's a little Hello Kitty one and Pokemon and other things that I do not know what they are.
The CEO of Disney.
Move over, Chapek. Tom Nook is taking over the company. I don't know if I have enough bells to pay for this vacation.
Don't stare into his eyes. You'll lose some money.
They have fans. We're a fan of the fans. They have some seaweed snacks. You can snack on some seaweed. No, not a fan.
I've had it. It's gross. I don't like it. No.
Okay. Good to know.
Hard no.
Hard no. So we were going to see the Disney on Broadway show, but the line is crazy. Like, it's just ending over here and we're like at the far end of Germany. So what we might do is we'll do some other stuff around the park and we might try to return later if the line is shorter, but we have the feeling that this might be something to skip, unfortunately. Which sucks, because I wanted to see it. That's what free concerts be like.
Yeah, really.
Carla, if you're watching, I know you want slash already have one of these. So cute! Of course, we got the treats that you can get of the respective countries. One of my favorite things in all of the World Showcase stores, even though I haven't purchased any yet. I really should one day. I don't know if that day will be today. Alright, so we just came off of Reflections of China, which was our first Circle Vision show. Well, have you seen a Circle Vision show before?
Well, yeah, I did everything.
Okay, well, I didn't. I thought it was cool. I wasn't expecting,
I wasn't expecting feel movement or anything. It doesn't move, but the way it surrounds you, tricks your eyes a little bit, that part was cool.
I really want to go to China now.
Yeah, me too. Like, it's basically like almost like a tourism promo, but which I think it kind of is meant to be, but... Yeah, I want to go. So many cool things there. Okay, so Frozen Ever After is down for the time being. That's okay, because we have another amazing boat ride here in the World Showcase, and that is the Grand Fiesta Tour. Upon walking in, we have some cool stuff. I do have to say I miss the original version of Test Track, but I mean, it's still a fun ride, and you haven't done 2.0 yet, have you? No. So this will be an experience for you. I love sharing these new experiences with you. But yeah, we're gonna go vroom very soon. Yeah. All right, Michael's busy designing our car. We have 16 seconds left, apparently. Nice. This is our car. We got 78 efficiency, 50 responsiveness, 46 power, and 34 capability.
Most of it's your fault.
Yeah. I thought we both have a chance to do it, but I guess not. I don't know how this works. It wasn't clear. All right, guys. We were successful in getting seats at the Disney on Broadway show. Oh my goodness, I'm so excited because this is the last show on the last day of the festival, and it has all the performers that were here all throughout the festival, so it's everyone, and it's gonna be great. I'm so excited.
Ashley Brown, Josh Strickland, Kissy Simmons, and Michael J. Scott.
I am what I wear and how I dress.
Sing it, princess.
Oh my goodness, I love that. I'm so glad we got to do it.
Yeah, me too.
The performers were great. I mean, obviously they're on Broadway. But yeah, no, that was incredible. I'm so glad we got to do that.
enough to lift the human spirit. Set the song inside you soaring, and the whole wide world will hear it.
And that, my friends, was my day at Epcot. I know I just said this in my last video, but what a crazy jam-packed day, just full of some awesome experiences. I mean, let's recap. I did a brand new ride. I got to experience a festival that I've always wanted to visit. And of course, I got to see the Broadway show, which was amazing. Oh, I was so worried that we weren't going to be able to see it. But, you know, with a bit of patience and planning, that Disney magic tends to pull through. Oh, and Harmonious, what an amazing show. I really enjoyed that. I mean, I loved Illuminations, and I'm gonna miss it, but I'd say this is definitely a worthy replacement. Coming up, Michael and I visit Hollywood Studios, where we step into the cartoon world of Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway, fight alongside the Resistance in Star Wars Galaxy's Edge, dash around with Slinky in Andy's backyard, and check into a hotel on the dark side of Hollywood. Anywhoomst, my laptop is not making the editing process easy, so I don't really know when I'm gonna have my next video available, but you know, I'll just keep working on them and they'll be out when they're out. But of course, if you don't want to miss any of my future Disney adventures or any of my other theme park travel, local and outdoor adventures that I do on the channel, be sure to subscribe. And given how haphazard my uploading has been recently, maybe hit that notification icon. That way you'll be notified whenever I release a new video. Also be sure to follow me on Instagram and Twitter at @adbparker. And of course, I have to plug my Patreon page and merch shop. I just launched those not too long ago. So if you're able to and you have a chance, just head on over and check those things out. Anyways, thank you again for watching. And until next time, have a magical week. Michael, you've taken your first